Hey, I'm Matthew Giorgio, the lead designer of this business simulation game. Let's play. I'm going to start a new game here. Hey, I'm Matthew Giorgio, the lead designer of this business simulation game. Let's play. All right, here we are in the big city. Now, before I was actually able to get to this big simulation here, I actually had to do some training on some simpler businesses. And so once I complete that training, then I was able to enter this big city with this very realistic simulation. In fact, the simulation we're going to play right now is the most realistic startup and operation simulation in the world. All right, so welcome to the big city. This is where we'll start and run our full businesses. This is the tutorial that's going to walk us through here. With a full business, we have many products to sell, multiple inventory items to manage, several employees to supervise, and many challenges to overcome. This is not going to be easy. Use your past business experience to set you up for success with this new business. So that's again referring to the training that I've already done. Take note of the clock. You have to properly manage your time because the clock will keep running while you're working. You can change the speed of the clock by clicking the clock or the slider under the time. So this is the clock that it's referring to. Everything runs by the clock, so you're actually managing your business minute by minute, hour by hour. The clock only stops when you go home or pause the game. You can choose when to go home each day by clicking the home icon. There we are. When you're home, you'll choose how much time to allocate to personal, family, and sleep. Home time improves your health. All right, so there's our health meter right here. And it looks like it's at 80% to start with. So it seems the more we work, if we work too many hours, our health will go down. And if we take time away from work, our health will go up. The clock has stopped right now to give you time to make your startup decisions. Okay, so we got plenty of time to think things through. Start on the company screen. Okay, so there's our menu at the bottom. We're at the company screen by making your first startup decisions. So the menu is not clickable right now because I'm in the tutorial. All right, let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so we have to choose our business type. And we're gonna run a restaurant in this particular example here. But there are other business types to choose from. And we can review our founder and CEO. So there I am, and there's my health level, and there's my seed financing. So it looks like I started with $60,000, but my startup services were $15,000 of that. So that's gonna use up a fair bit of that $60,000 that we started with. And we're a limited liability corporation. We own 100% of the shares. We'll actually be able to sell shares later on if we like. All right, let's choose a name and logo for our business. So I'm going to call this Foodies, the name of my business, and we can choose a logo for it. This looks interesting. Let's choose that one. And now we have to choose a location. All right, so I can see there's three locations, the shopping district, the park, and Main Street. And so the park, I'm guessing, would be good for maybe people taking some time off away from work, just want to enjoy some time in the park. Probably not so good if the weather's not good. So I can see the actual weather in the weather forecast here. So on good days the park will probably be crowded, and on bad weather days probably not so much. Main Street seems to be kind of the downtown core. That's where probably people are looking for quick lunch or something like that. And then the shopping center, which is like a mall. So I can actually review consumer profiles here. So this will give me some demographic and psychographic information about my customers. And so I can see, you know, what they want. So I'm thinking about Main Street, and I can see that Main Street, they want quick service and a little bit of business reputation and a balance of price and quality. Okay, so that's kind of the main things I want to look at there. And the weather has very little effect on traffic, because you know people have to go to work regardless of the weather. And I can see customer traffic, so Main Street. I can see Mondays, every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays. They're all pretty evenly distributed, so there's that's where most of the traffic. Not much traffic on the weekends, some, but not much. Compared to, you know, maybe the shopping center where it has a lot of its traffic on the weekends, and same with the park. Okay, all right, let's scroll down further. And these are the, this is customer traffic by hour. So if the Main Street is red, I can see that we're going to have peak traffic right around lunchtime. So 12, 1 p.m., anywhere from, I guess, 11 to 1 p.m. is peak traffic. That's like 14% of my customers are all going to come around that time. And then we have some breakfast traffic, it looks like here, and then some kind of early supper or early dinner traffic as well. Interesting. Okay, so that's going to help me with my setup. So let me go ahead and choose Main Street. Say okay. All right, cool. All right, so well done. Next, you have to make operations decisions. Click the operations button below. Let's do that. Choose a site for your business. Okay, so this is kind of the building that we're going to be in. So we can choose economy, quality, or premium. Rent $1,500 per month, and this is $2,500, and this is $4,000. You know, the leaseholds are $3,000. So leaseholds are what we have to pay right up front to kind of renovate the space to suit our needs. So the best thing here is to actually start with the economy because it's least expensive, and then as our capacity to serve more customers increases, then we should upgrade to the larger facilities. And you can see there's actual capacity. So this one only has like just a little bit more than 25%, more than a quarter of the capacity of the premium. So when we start getting a lot of customers, that's when I'll have to level up. But for now, we got to preserve cash because we only have a certain amount of startup cash. So I'm going to choose the economy. So let's do that. All right, well done. Now click equipment in the submenu below. Some birds chirping in our game here. I'm going to lower that volume a bit. All right, so we've got to choose equipment. Okay, so this is our restaurant equipment. So we've got starter, deluxe, prime. So the difference here is that this is used and this is new. And also the capacities. So I can see the capacity. That's how many customers I can serve in like around the same time. That increases based on the cost and size of the equipment. Okay, so again, I think I should start with the lowest cost and then move up. So I've got the choice between 5,000 used or 10,000 new. One's under warranty, one isn't. And actually this one has a little bit more capacity too. So you know what, I think I'm gonna choose this one. Now we actually can sell this equipment later when we wanna upgrade, we can sell it, but I think we're only gonna get a certain percentage if we sell. I think it's like 30% if we of what we originally paid for it. But you know, if you're growing, you've got to do that. So anyway, let's go ahead and choose starter new. Well done. Now click schedule in the submenu below. All right, so your business is not yet scheduled to open for customers. This allows you time to prepare your business, such as ordering and receiving inventory, hiring employees, and other activities. Once you're ready to serve customers, return to the screen to set your operating hours. We cannot set them right now. Okay, so this is where we would set our operating hours. All right, let's continue. Click documents in the submenu below. New businesses must register with the government, qualify for permits, and pay for a variety of business services. Everything your business needs has already been set up for you, and you can review the costs on this document screen. So I can see that there's business registration and tax ID. So right now I can't actually click, but I think if I've come back to the screen, I'll be able to look at these in more detail. So some of these are one-time costs, and some of them are recurring costs. And if you remember, we had a $15,000 startup. So a lot of that $15,000 is actually used by these services that we had to incur. And we haven't paid for them yet. They've invoiced us, so we're gonna have to pay them in a minute. All right, now click the finance button below. These are your payables, here they are, which are bills or money that you owe. You must frequently return to the screen and click the amount you want to pay on each payable. You must do this, otherwise you'll risk going bankrupt. I also happen to know that the benefit of paying bills quickly is it'll help our business reputation. So if you pay people quickly, they like doing business with you, so it'll help build up goodwill with our vendors. All right, so your new startup business is launched and the clock has started. Oh, okay, look, the clock is moving now. You're on your own now, good luck. All right, okay, so we're on our own. We're not scheduled to open yet. And we gotta start making some decisions, all right? So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually slow down the clock just a little bit. So we can do that by clicking on the clock and adjusting the speed. Or we can use this little slider and click on slower speed, and you'll see the clock is slowed down now. So this gives us more time. I think there's five settings here. We can really slow it down. So sometimes it's going to be beneficial for us to speed up the clock and sometimes to slow it down. Because, you know, the more days we can get through our business, the more chance we have of making profit and growing our business. So we want to go quickly, but we don't want to go so quickly that we're unable to make decisions, right? You know, if I'm trying to make some decisions, the customers are coming and I'm trying to serve them and all that, it's going to be too difficult. So we'll be adjusting that as we go. But right now there's no pressure because we're not yet scheduled to open for business. So let's do a couple things. Let's take a look at those documents that we looked at. So for example, insurance. And so this is going to cover most of our costs. So we can see what, you know, what insurance is and how much it costs. We can look at business registration. So I see there's a $1,500 startup fee, and we're going to be charged a yearly fee of $250 as well. So we can review all of those things. Let's go to our finance, and here's all the bills that we owe. Let's go ahead and actually pay those bills, because I don't like owing money for a very long period of time, especially if I have the money to pay somebody. I'd rather just pay them off, so let's go ahead and do that. All right, great. So we don't owe anybody any money, although look at our cash. It went down from 60,000 to 24,000. That's because not only do we have the startup, but we also had the site with our rent and the equipment that we had to buy and the leaseholds that we had to pay for. All right, so it costs money here to run a business like this. All right, so let's go to our products. Let's see what we're selling. Okay, so it's a restaurant. I can see I've got a hamburger and I can click on it. See, hamburger, french fries, chicken strips, salad, chicken wrap, vegetable wrap, cola, juice, coffee, water, pie for dessert. Oh, we got bacon and eggs, that's good. And ice cream sundae. Okay, so we got everything here, great. I can see there's no quality yet. That's because I know we don't have any inventory. And there's the price, so there's a default price, but I can change the price. Like, let's say on our hamburger, instead of $4, you know, we can make it, a little bit more. Let's just go $4.20. Anyway, I probably shouldn't be tweaking the prices yet until I get some feedback from my customers or see how much this stuff costs. All right, so most of this is empty because I haven't got any sales. So let's go to inventory. All right, so this is where I have to buy all the ingredients that make everything. All right, so I can see like there's hamburger meat. So if I go back to products and look at hamburger, it's a flame broiled hamburger in a bun. Okay, that's cool. Let's go back to inventory for a second, and actually there's some tabs up here and I can see usage. So it shows me how each inventory item is used. So I can see a hamburger meat. I need one serving of hamburger meat for a hamburger. All right. And actually buns, that's used in a hamburger as well. So I need buns and you know, some other things. But anyway, I'm gonna buy everything because I wanna sell everything. So let's go back to our inventory aging, yep, that's the right one. And now we're gonna go to our suppliers. Okay, so we have different suppliers to choose from. And I can see these are our suppliers. These guys say our food may be frozen, but so are our low prices. Okay, so they've often, looks like they're positioning themselves as the lowest cost provider, but frozen food. So maybe the quality's not as good there. And then to see top meats and artisan bakery. So that sounds like top quality meat if I wanna have really great burgers and chicken and so on. Your best value supplier for quality and price, I like that. Premium beverages, okay, so I can, looks like I can buy drinks at a good price just from these guys, but it says just beverages, so that means they only sell beverages. And Farmroy, locally sourced organic foods. Okay, that sounds expensive, but also sounds delicious and what a lot of customers might want these days. All right, so we got some decisions to make. This is our shipping options. Okay, so we got to worry about shipping. So who's got the fastest shipping? Because I want to get started selling right away. Okay, so I've got one and one. Yeah, it looks like the fastest I'm going to get is prices. That's the frozen food. Okay, so that may not be where I want to stay, but just for the sake of getting some sales as soon as possible, I'm going to go with prices. So let's go ahead and order inventory. So I'm going to choose prices as the supplier. And this shows me everything that they have available for sale. And this looks like they sell everything, which is good. Let me just check M&B. That's the meat and bread. So meat and bread only has meat and bread. So I wouldn't be able to get all my stuff from this supplier. So I could get maybe just my meats here, just my bread or both, and then get the rest from other suppliers. So I'm gonna have to experiment to see who's gonna give me the kind of best price and best quality. And actually look at the quality of this of these guys' ingredients, 100%. So this is the best quality ingredients. Now let's go to prices where we're going to look at. Okay, the prices, look, the quality is half as good. So that's not gonna be as great for my customers. What about prices? Just look here, $1 for hamburger meat. What about, yeah, M&B. Oh, hamburger meat's $2, so it's twice as expensive. But better quality. So, if I go with these guys later, I'm probably gonna have to raise my prices. But if customers want better quality, they're probably willing to pay a little bit more for it. So anyway, I'll have to keep that in mind for later. So right now, let's just get some inventory and start making some sales. All right, so I'm gonna click on this one. Instead of just clicking how many I want, I'm gonna use this quantity discounts here. This will allow me to quickly get a bunch, and I get discounts if I buy more higher quantities, which is good. We keep that in mind as well as we figure out our best patterns for ordering inventory. So lots of experimenting we're gonna have to do to figure out, how much inventory we're selling, what's the top sellers, how much we have to buy, if people are liking our products and our quality and so on. All right, so we got 100 everything. Let's go ahead and select expedited shipping so we can get it in 1 day plus 1 day delivery. So it's still going to take a couple of days. It's going to cost a hundred and some bucks just for delivery. Actually, 170 just for delivery. Wow, that's because we want it fast. So you got to pay for it. All right, so inventory ordered. So now we got to wait for it to come. That's okay. We've got other things we can do. So we can review the order. Here's the order we just placed, and we can look at it. And I can see I can duplicate the order. So that'll make it easy if I want to keep ordering the same order every time. I don't have to click all those times. All right, so that's cool. Let's close that. All right, so that's all of our products area. Let's take a look at employees. Okay, so we've got me, the founder and CEO, and I'm working in the business but not taking a salary. Okay, to keep your living costs low, you're living a frugal lifestyle and paying your costs with personal savings. Keep this in mind when reviewing the profits and cash flow for your business because they would be impacted if you were taking a salary. So basically, what this is telling us is that we're not getting paid as owners and operators of the business. However, if we generate profit in the business, then that profit could be our pay. So the more profit we generate, the more salary we can pull out of the business. Let's see. Okay, job applicants. All right, so these are all the employees we can hire. But you know what? I'm not going to hire any employees yet. I'm going to skip over this for now. Let's just try to make some sales. I'm not going to do any marketing either because that's kind of, that I got to make some good decisions. I don't want to waste my money until I know that I'm getting some customers and making some money. So let's go ahead and try to get to some sales as quickly as possible. Now I'm just doing this so that we can make those sales fast. I wouldn't normally do this if I was trying to do really well here, but all right, so you notice the clock has been ticking all this time, so it's 5 p.m. Let's go home. So we're gonna click on the home icon here, and it looks like, yeah, it's at 30 minutes commute time. So it looks like it takes 30 minutes for us to go home and then 30 minutes to come back. So let's go ahead and choose, let's see, we're gonna choose, oops, I clicked the wrong one there. That's okay. It's midnight now, and this is the end of day report. Now there's no numbers here. We'll look at this later when we actually have some sales. It looks like I got to work kind of early this morning. Let me accelerate that time clock and get that time moving a little bit faster. Now again, I don't actually have inventory. It hasn't arrived yet. I think we still need another day to get there. So rather than, I mean, I can spend some time looking at other parts of my business and so on, but rather than do that, I'm going to actually just go home again. And now I'm gonna choose a proper time. I'm going to get to work, let's say, at just before 7 a.m. or around 7 a.m. with commute time here. All right. And we have to set our operating hours too. We can't forget that, because otherwise we're not open. All right, so our progress is saved. So the simulation saves every simulated day. All right, let's see, do we have, has our inventory arrived yet? Still not yet. I think it's gonna arrive, it might actually arrive this afternoon, but let's open tomorrow. So while we're waiting for that to happen, oh, look, it's arrived. Let's slow down that clock. Hold on, slow down that clock. All right, so we've got inventory. Let's go and look. We can close that. Oh, there we go. We're ready to rock and roll here. Okay, so now let's open up our business. So what time is it? 10 a.m. The clock's ticking. Let's try to get this rush hour. What day is it? Wednesday. Okay, let's set our operating hours for Wednesday. By the time I finish this, it's going to be like 11 o'clock. So let's open at 11 and let's go a little late today. Let's go till 8. See if we can serve a bunch of customers. And we also want to open on Thursday as well. Let's go ahead at 8 a.m. to 7. And then Friday, same thing. And we'll do this. We'll set this up for every day. And we can change every day. As you can see, every day can be different. Sunday, you know what? Let's open for brunch, kind of breakfast brunch on Sunday and lunch, and just leave it at that. And then Monday, same thing. We can come in here and change these at any time, you know, as we're discovering more information about our sales and our customers. Let's do one more hour for today, try to make a little bit more money. Don't have any employees to schedule yet, so there's no employees. So that's okay, because we want to figure out what's going on first before we spend money on employees and marketing and so on. All right, let's close this down. There's our building, by the way. There's our business right there. And there's going to be how many products we're selling and our revenue. And that's us right there, our little icon. Let's move the clock up faster so we can get to 11 o'clock and open for business and get some excitement happening here. All right, here we go. Here come our customers. There they are, these little dots. Although those dots are going to be little people in a short while, but they represent people at the moment. Look, this is the feedback from our customers that's appearing above, and you can hear a ding. That ding is a sale, and that little blurb that we hear, that blurb is a missed sale. So we can see here this little X, we're missing out on sales for some reason. Oh no, something's off. So we'll have to figure this out. And you can see the little happy faces, or if they're sad faces, that's the customer feedback. If our customers are happy or not. And then these icons that appear. If an icon appears on the left side of the face, to our left of the face, that means something negative is happening. And if icon appears on the right-hand side of the face, that means there's positive feedback from the customers. And if no icon appears, that means it's neutral feedback. Because in the real world, most customers don't actually give you feedback. It's kind of, if they're not really happy or really unhappy, they're usually not going to say anything. So what we're seeing here is basically people who are really happy or quite unhappy, and we've definitely run into some problems here because we're losing a lot of sales. That's okay though, because this is just our first day in business. We'll figure things out. That's part of this experience, is to actually run into problems, fail on certain things, and then learn from that and continue to improve, because you definitely learn a lot more from making mistakes than you do if everything went well really easily. All right, so we're gonna look and see what's going on here. While that's happening, let's take a look to see if we can see what's happening here. Oh, look at that. We ran out of oil, seasoning, and condiments, which are used in pretty well everything that we make. And that's what's our killer here. All right, so lesson learned here, that we should have really ordered a lot more of that item, and we would have made a lot more sales for the day. All right, so I think we're just about ready to close the business. All right, there we go, it's closed. Let me slow down the clock now to give us a little bit more time to figure things out. So we've served 92, I think we've sold 92 products and lost out on 114. Our revenue for the day is 280, so not a great day. Now what I really should do is I should actually go to my products and immediately order inventory. And again, I'm going to have to go to prices with expedited shipping to try to increase this quantity. You know, if I'm going to do 500 this time, and I can still, everything else looks like it's still okay. Like a lot of things I didn't sell, mostly because, you know, like you couldn't cook them because I ran out of this important ingredient. But let me, since I'm here, let me go and order a little bit of everything just to have. Although, you know, I'm not going to order more meats and stuff because the quality will actually degrade over time, so I don't want to do that. So let's place that order. All right, we're good. It's getting late. I'm going to have to get home soon. Don't want to get impacted with negative health here. But before we do that, let's go ahead and look at our reports. And we can look at customer feedback. So this will show us what kind of feedback we're going to get from customers. Now, it only shows us up until the day before, so we have to wait for this day to be over before we're going to see the results of that. Same with our customers served. Yeah, we'll come back to those tomorrow. Let's close this for now, and let's go home and get started early on the next day. Let's see. We want to get to work around 7:30 the next day. Okay, so there's the end of our day. We served 36 customers. That's much lower than I was hoping for. We lost 114 customers. Wow. Sold 92 products. And sales revenue, $280. Cost of goods, so that's all the ingredients that we use to make our products, $120. So our gross profit is $159, and our gross profit margin, 57%. Now, I happen to know in the restaurant business, a gross profit margin should probably be around 60, 70, maybe even as high as 75%. That's essentially your food costs and your preparation costs. Of course, gross profit and gross margin don't tell you everything. There's a whole bunch of other costs that we have to deal with, like our rent, for example, and our utilities and so on, that are not reflected in gross profit. They're actually reflected in another number called net profit, which we can see. I can also see that some of my items, some of my inventory items were either discarded or got spoiled, and so I lost $1.30 of value there. So I have to be careful not to have too much inventory on hand that's not going to sell. Otherwise, I could lose out there. All right, so let's commute. All right, so we're back to work the next day. Now, I don't think I want to open today because, you know, remember, I ran out of inventory. And so I'm going to, the same thing will happen to me here. So I'm actually going to close. Today's Thursday. I'm going to close today. And on Friday, I might get my inventory, but it's probably not going to come until late. So let's not open until 11. There we go. So I've made plans for now the next 2 days. And I think I'm going to get it. I may not even get it tomorrow. Let's see. The inventory, we'll have to wait and see for that. But let's go ahead and look at our reports. Remember, we're going to look at our feedback. Okay, so there we go. So we can see now that day three, we lost 6 customers because of service. So that means my service was slow, which means that I was the only one working, and so I couldn't serve as many customers came in at that time. So that's where I might have to hire employees now. I'm not ready to do that yet because, you know, remember, we lost a lot of customers here because of our inventory. So I want to see what my numbers are like when I have enough inventory to serve everybody, right? I don't want to start making decisions on 5 different variables at the same time. So we want to kind of isolate the variables. I can see one person we lost or was unhappy. We didn't necessarily lose them, but they were unhappy because of price. And a whole bunch of people not too happy with quality. So remember, we bought all the frozen food, so the quality is not as good. And so a lot of people not so happy with quality. Now, I could probably improve that if I lower my prices, because, you know, people are willing to forgive you on quality if you charge them a low price. If, you know, if they feel like, look, I'm not paying much, so I'm kind of getting what I pay for. I think we can be a little bit forgiven if we were to lower our prices a bit. Or the other option, of course, is to increase our quality, to buy better inventory. And we lost almost everybody because of inventory, as you can see here, and capacity too. So we actually lost some people because of either our equipment or our site capacity. And we got no positive feedback, but don't worry about that. I think we might get some. We might get some in the next day. So here's our customer served and lost, so we can see a little bit more details about why we lost customers. And our customer satisfaction wasn't too bad, 71%, so it's not terrible. All right, so let's go ahead and close that. Let's advance to the next day. Let's speed up the clock a little bit here. Oh no, what happened? Okay, so we're going to advance the next day here. There we go. Hopefully our inventory will arrive and then we can actually open for business. There we go. Get ready. There's our end of day. We're going to skip through that very quick. And on our way back to work. Commuting, that 30-minute commute is a killer here. So using up some good sales time and work time that that we may need. All right, so let's speed up the clock. Get this show on the road here. See if we can get our inventory to arrive, and so we can start making some money. Okay, our progress is saved, so that's good. Come on, inventory. Uh-oh, we're scheduled to open. Remember, we scheduled to open today, and it's here we go. We're open for business, and we don't have enough inventory. Oh, it hasn't arrived. Oh no. And you know what? I don't think we can actually close now. I'm not sure we're gonna. Oh, inventory received. Good news. Good news. All right. Do you hear those dings? That ding. That's great. Cash register clicking up here. Okay, look at that. We're getting lots of good dings. And we're not getting many bloops here. In other words, we're not losing many customers. Oh, we lost one there. And look at the feedback. Customers looking reasonably happy, but quality, not very happy with our quality. Not very happy with the quality. Oh, look at this. We're running out of something again. What did we run out of here? Let's look at our products, our inventory. Ran out of potatoes. Got to pay attention to my inventory. All right, well, that we'll let that go. Let's take a look at our employees, because I think at some point we're going to be probably going to be losing some customers now due to service. And so let's look at our employees here. So here's what we can do is we can review different employees. Oh, there's our end of day. And we've served 68 customers, so did a lot better than yesterday. Still lost a lot. Made a lot more money today. Gross profit margin still on the lower side, but much better than the day before. So we're definitely improving. Let's go ahead and slow down that clock because it's already past midnight, and we're out of potatoes as well. So let's see what we're going to do here. So we can look at different employees, and we look at their work experience and education. I can click on employee. Let's go ahead with let's fire somebody who's kind of affordable here to get started. So Jian. Let's see here. Food service skills, not too great. Not too great. Customer service skills, not too great. But she's only asking $12 an hour. And others are a lot more expensive. But let's try Maria here. Okay, Maria is looking good here. Customer service is high. Food service, some experience, not too much, but $14. Let's see. Let's go ahead and offer her $14 an hour. Job offer accepted. Good news. All right, so we have an employee. So now what we could do is we can go and schedule Maria in the schedule here and looking at employees by week. We can look at Maria, for example. So this shows us our operating hour. So what's today? Saturday. So let's say I wanted to work tomorrow, Sunday. I could add her to work at specific hours in the day, or maybe the entire shift for the day. And then on Monday, I can do the same thing. Have her work maybe just the rush hour lunchtime, because that's when I think I might need the most help. In fact, you know what? Let's reduce our hours here just until we figure out, how to do better and how to make money here before we spend too much money. So that's how we can do employees. We also have the option of actually including benefits as part of the compensation package. So we could do health insurance and so on, and their percentage of salary. So if I turn it on for my employees, then all employees will get these benefits. But you know, they're not cheap to offer. They're kind of expensive, but it might keep the morale up and keep their productivity up and increase their loyalty to the business. So it's probably a good idea to invest in some of these things as we start generating a little bit of money, and we can actually invest in those things. We can eventually train our employees, review HR reports to see if their employees are showing up for work and so on. And then we can start marketing. So once we figure out, you know, that we're making money, the next step would be to start marketing our business. And here we can look at business reputation, and it's made up of four different metrics like customer satisfaction, employee morale, and so on. And then our advertising effectiveness. We don't have any yet because we haven't actually started advertising. So we can invest in things like signage and experience and appearance and customer service and product quality. And we can put on a sale and see if that attracts more customers. We can invest in actual advertising options here. But to do that, we have to review our various customer psychographics, different consumer segments, and decide who we're going to target, because we can't target everybody. For example, I can see here that if I want to target people who are time sensitive, right, which we recognize that we're in the main street, so a lot of people are time sensitive, that's the green bar. So this group M6 is the most time sensitive, so I'm probably going to target them, and then maybe 1 and 2, because they're also the biggest green bars, again, most time sensitive. So I want to target 6, 1, and 2. So when I go to targeting, I would identify the consumer groups I want to target, so 6, 1, and 2. So I might put, 30% of my focus on them, and 30% on them, and the rest, 40% on them. So now I'm 100%. And then I can, experiment with this and come back and actually see how well my targeting is working. I do the same with messaging. So here I can use keywords. So depending on the type of restaurant I want to run, it's like, do I want to run a quick service, low cost restaurant, like your fast service, fast food, quick serve, low prices. I think those are the kind of affordable value meals. Those are the kind of keywords I think will attract my consumers. I can see things like gourmet, but if I'm offering frozen foods, it's not really gourmet. And if I use the term gourmet, it's not going to resonate well with my target. So this is kind of interesting. We have to really think about the keywords we can target. We can choose up to 8 of them for each consumer group here, and then come back and experiment to see how well each one is doing. And then different media options as well. So I can see which type of media, whether it's TV or social media or events or sponsorships, are the best way to reach my particular customers. And again, I can allocate a percentage of my budget to these areas and then come back and see how well it's working and then adjust it. So every few days I can come back here, adjust it, see if I can improve my targeting and so on. So lots going on in this simulation. Let's go ahead and close that. I can also, under the menu, I can control various things like the music and sound effects and so on. And if I go back to reports, I can bring up balance sheets so I can understand the value that I'm building in my business. I can bring up income statements and see if I, how I'm making money, where a lot of my money is going, and all sorts of other reports in terms of products I'm selling. And the finance, I can apply for loans or sell shares in my business. Oh, I can see I've got some bills I gotta pay as well. And then the last thing here was, this is our performance report. So this will actually assess our behavior in terms of our performance in the simulation. So it's actually going to give me a skill score. So we're not doing very well right now. 32% is pretty low skill score, but we're just getting started. So we've got to kind of build up our success as we go along, and it's going to rate us on finance and leadership and sales and marketing and operations and how well we treat our employees. And we even have micro learning built in as well, which is kind of cool. So we can learn a variety of things in micro learning. That's micro learning's under here, where if we want to learn certain topics, whether it's about learn about marketing or finance or accounting, we can actually watch videos and do quizzes and so on here, and refine our knowledge and then apply what we're learning in this micro learning into for example, I can click on that, and then it'll bring up the micro learning module. for businesses and products, where we can watch a video and then review what we saw in the video, and then actually do some quizzes to confirm that what we learned. Cool. All right. So that's us playing the simulation. Now, we could play this for hours and hours and hours and hours, and then we try different business types as well, which would be kind of cool, and just keep improving our business and keep learning in this very realistic business simulation. Hope you enjoyed this walkthrough.